Nico, come on over here and grab a thing. Nico, of course, is our former intern. And what do you know, knife salesman or something? I forget what you were doing.
I was doing insurance.
How'd that work out for you?
Oh, not good.
You had to sell insurance to people that were only 69?
Yeah, to really, really old people. And it was just the saddest thing, just calling them up and bothering the hell out of them.
Now, back in 2007, you bum-rushed the Grease 2 bowling party. Why did you do that?
Well, I could have sworn I was invited, but this is ridiculous. Where was Dave saying?
No, you weren't invited.
I remember one of the girls saying that Dave felt sorry for you that night.
Yeah, no, I remember. I was there. I was at the time you were my intern, and I was like a little bit embarrassed because I was bowling with Anthony, and we were having beers and having a good time. Then Nico comes in with his custom made bowling glove, and everyone was like, "Who's that loser?"
Nice. Now, are you a bowler? You roll?
Yeah, I am a bowler.
What's your average?
My average is 182.
182 seems extremely strong to me.
Good, man.
That's a hell of an average.
Yeah, I've been bowling for years.
Now, do you think that this kid rolled 250?
No, absolutely not.
Now, you look at this prick right now. If I backed you against him, Nico, in a cash money game, could you beat him?
Absolutely.
Whoa. Ooh. We have to do this.
And let me say this, and I'm saying it, the fucking Hicks and Dave... Fuck you and your boy. Watley, you're on my team.
Yes.
You're on my team, Team Nico, right now.
All right. If we back $20?
No.
If we back, come on. We don't have that much kind of money.
Well, you do have something else. You have humiliation. Watley, for their humiliation, how much money are you willing to put up?
Oh, I will put up a grand to split between them.
Freddy.
Oh,
better practice.
No, we're fucking leaving right here, right now, prick.
I'll do a 900 series.
No, Ray, take this seriously. Nico's already coming in serious, I can tell.
Nico, here's the problem. All right, Fez is putting up a grand. The thing is, Nico, you have a born loser thing about you that scares me.
Have you done? Nico cannot decide. Should I grow the hair in? Should I shave it off? Grow it in?
How old are you, Nico?
I think the hair can't decide.
23.
You're a fucking mess. You come in here looking like a cancered gonad. It just looks like he's had some kind of problems.
Or someone entering a Jeff Van Gundy lookalike contest.
I can't help my hair's leaving me.
You're pushing it out.
There's something weird going on. You're jerking off too much.
You're saying that you could beat this kid?
Definitely.
Nico.
Frey's got good hair.
Are you 100% sure you can win this?
Oh, absolutely. You're going down, boy.
I will say this, Ryan. Nico's, he had his own glove and was very intense that night.
Sure.
How did he roll, though? How good was he?
I don't believe he got to 180, honestly. I believe, Nico, you had like a solid, 150. But I don't believe you got that high. I remember because you came in talking a lot of game, and then I paid attention, and you
From what I heard, he stunk that night.
Yeah. Well, no, he didn't. It wasn't that he was terrible. He just wasn't up to his own hype. Now, if Freddy lives up to even a half of his hype, we'll be in good shape.
Freddy's a liar.
Believe the hype.
Rob in Atlanta, you're on Run and Fez.
Oh, hey, guys. Yeah, I mean, for this guy to average 250, he's got to average like 9-10 strikes a game, and in which case
he's not.
That I do.
You're
not. I do.
Like yes, I do.
He'd have 300 games like every week.
It doesn't make sense.
Maybe if the lane was shaped like a stick of celery, he could bowl 250 average.
That's hysterical. Yeah. Let's go to Matt, South Carolina. You're on Run and Fez.
Hey boys. Yeah. Hey, I bowl. Twice a year. And I had a fluke game. I scored 238. I missed three total pins. There's no way this guy shoots averages 250.
He did for a while.
You're both.
For a while. I'm starting to believe him now.
But do you stink, Nico?
No.
Fezzi's putting a G-bow in.
Yeah. Last week I just pulled a 177, a 205, and then a 215.
I feel good about that.
I like
what are
that.
The last three games you bowled?
250, 275, and a 280.
You're such a fucking liar.
That's like a 260 average then, by the way.
I was above my average that night.
He was above it the last three games. I think Freddie's telling the truth here.
Let's go over to, let's go to Chris and PA. You're on Run and Fez.
Yeah. I own a pro shop. I drill bowling balls. My highest average for a year was 209, and I know I'm not good enough to bowl on tour. My question for him is this: what brand and model bowling ball does he use?
It's a Brunswick.
Okay.
Look, you hear the goddamn bowling thing.
Lane number six is open.
This guy is an expert. He's calling your shit out.
I can have a Brunswick rep there tomorrow with a check to sign you up if you're a 250.
Wow. Let's do it. Sponsorship.
We're putting you on the road, kid.
There is no way.
He did. He said he did. What reason would he lie?
The PBA sends me letters all the time.
You're a liar, Freddie. I want you to start swearing to God as an Italian.
The Police Benevolent Association?
What kind?
Benevolent?
Oh, God. Jason in North Carolina.
Yeah, if he bowled a 250 game, that means he's averaged out a couple 300 games. And I know pro bowlers. So where's his rings at? Everybody's proud to wear these damn 300-game rings. So where's your rings at, Freddie?
He claims he got a 298, was his highest game.
Yeah, that was my highest game.
Even with a 298, you get a silver ring. Yeah, so where's that ring at?
11 strikes in a row, you get a ring, because my friend just got one.
Yeah, that wasn't in my league, though.
You know what? Unless it's a league of liars, no one believes you.
I'm telling the truth.
He is.
I remember... it was after the day, after the bowling was over, like the league itself, and we would just hang around and bowl and shoot after, and that's when I got
it. You keep saying shoot.
Yeah.
Does anyone call it shoot, Nico?
No, I've never heard.
Heard the term shoot.
And it sounds like you weren't even in the league when you bowled this 298.
It was the league of really ordinary gentlemen.
So what?
I was in a league. I shot the 298 after the day of bowling was over. We would do three games.
What's the lowest game you've ever had?
Lowest game? Well, in recent years, like a 130. I mean, when I was younger, I used to get like a 99 or something like that.
That was when he was way younger, though.
That was like when I was four or something.
Yeah, he was like four.
Couldn't lift the balls.
5 years old.
Let me tell you something, Nico. I've learned to hate you today because I hate liars. And just because you look like a bowling ball doesn't make you a great bowler. Nico, you sure you can beat him?
Oh, absolutely destroy him.
No way.
You're getting buried.
Here is, let's go over to Justin, your manifest.
Hey, Ronnie. I actually just recently bowled a 300, and I'm about a 200 average. You should have seen how pissed off, first of all, this guy's a liar. You should have seen how pissed off the real bowlers were that some drunk was in there and actually rolled a 300. But I heard him talking about a 900 series, and I think that's only been done about 14 times in the history of the world where somebody's actually bowled three 300 games in league play. So,
wow.
Guys,
I'm gonna take a break here, and I'm going to ask Pepper and Dave what they'd be willing to do for this $1,000 bet from Fez if Fez wins. It's got to equal $1,000 in humiliation, or I'm pulling Watley out of this.
Okay, we'll think of something.
It's right
you
there for
you. Have until the end of this break, Dave, to come back. You get a one-time offer only. Here's the humiliating thing that we will do if Nico beats Freddy for the $1,000 that Fez is handing out.
Okay.
Now, here's the deal. If he turns it down, none of this happens. So you better go deep, and you better mean it.
Okay.
And Freddie, you will lay down. I fucking guarantee you.
I will not. I will get that 900 series. I'll be number 15 in the world.
I'll guarantee you this. Not only will you not bowl a 200, you won't bowl a 180. You will not do it. Because we're all going to be watching you, you choke artist. All right? And we will see you for the liar that you are.
I got a lot of pressure on me.
Yes, you do.
Don't let's do it, Freddie.
I will not let you down, Dave.
Just getting your fingers in the ball.
Don't get psyched out by this, Freddie.
No.
I want you to huddle up like Family Feud.
We are.
And if you guys don't come back with something that's just ball dropping, this contest doesn't take place.
Okay.
Nico, are you the man you claim you are?
That's right.
My partner is putting up $1,000 for you.
Yeah, I believe in you. You came in here telling the truth. You came in here at least telling a truth that made sense.
Yeah, you're a lying sack of crap.
And Fezzy, when this kid bowls and wins for you,
mm-hmm.
I want you to manage his radio career.
Okay.
I want you to make sure he gets a radio gig. All right, we're going to break. We come back. It's the one chance for Dave and Hicks to put up some $1,000 worth of humiliation. And they better get it in one shot only. Let's see what they offer.
Okay.
It's the round of fish. All right, we're getting ready to do the bowling contest. And Freddy is such a liar. Nico, you know that he's lying. You could just look at him.
Yeah. Look at that stance. Look at that short demeanor.
Okay. I like it. Now, let me tell you what a fucking nut this Freddy kid is. I give him $2 to run down the machine to get me a protein bar, right? He comes back with my protein bar and 5 quarters. So it's a 75 fucking cent bar, but he makes sure I gotta carry fucking coin around in my pocket all day. How do you even do this? You know I hate fucking silver.
I knew that.
What am I, a pirate?
I put the $2 in, and then I looked at the fucking bar and saw it was 75 cents. And I'm like,
you're not
shit.
Smart enough to go running around to fucking get somebody to make change so the asshole doesn't fucking bust your balls on the air? This is the opportunity. And they get one, because if they come limping in here, $1,000 will not work for the bet. Well, maybe I say it goes on, but these guys got to put up $1,000 if they're not fucking gross enough. Davey Mac, do you guys feel like you got something gross enough worth $1,000?
Yes, I do.
All right.
Very really fucking do. Horrifying, to be honest.
Now, do you believe in Freddy? This
believe,
kid you've been pushing
Freddy,
on me.
Yeah, fuck yeah.
I'm going to tell you right now, Hicks, and I'm going to talk to you like you were a son. This fucking kid's an idiot. I hate to see you betting money on him. Normally, I like to see a mark get fucking played. But this Freddy, you can see a guy like him coming a million miles away.
I believe in it. Nico says his best game was 220. That's 30 below Freddy's average. So I believe in him.
It's just math, Ron. Below it's math.
Here. Here's the thing is. There's not a sport I would ever bet on Nico in, but
what an awful sport bowling is.
But he owns his own glove, yes. And he's wearing a volunteer fireman fucking sweatshirt today. You're a volunteer fireman, right?
That's correct.
You roll with the other firemen?
No, actually, I'm the only one in my firehouse that does it. But
you're the only Jew that bowls that I know of.
And John Goodman, Big Lebowski. He doesn't roll on Shaman Shabbos.
Shomer Shabbos,
whatever. I ain't stuff. No Jew.
All right. Now, you guys claim that you got something that's so gross it's worth $1,000.
Well, listen, I'm not happy about this at all, but, I mean, Pepper is very manly, man.
Right.
And as far as I know, never even done a stunt on the Ron Fez show. So this idea popped into my head instantly, and he was very hard to get this, but he says he's on board.
All right. What do you want to do?
There are these things. I'm going to show you an example. And there are these things out there called gay beard porn videos. And it's just two gentlemen sitting in their underwear. And Pepper and I will be in our underwear on a bed. And they simply take their beards and nuzzle them on each other. And it can go not just the face, but furthermore, it can go onto the it can go on the body. It can go everywhere that we want.
Disgusting.
It is disgusting. Oh, God.
Wait a minute. Who's this guy?
And take your socks off, motherfucker.
These videos God, are very popular. That. They're being played everywhere. So Pepper and I will begrudgingly reenact one of these beard videos.
Now, it doesn't seem that horrifying to me.
Oh, it's bad.
In terms of... Watley's putting up a Jeebo.
Yeah, $1,000, and look at my track record. Diaper Hitler mustache. People, painted blue in a loincloth.
It's gay porn. This is gay porn that people actually pay money for these videos. I'm showing you, you know, ones that...
There's not even any kissing.
Why would there be? It's disgusting.
It's all about the beard. But the beard can go on the chest. It can go
all
everywhere.
All right, let me
it's
just
fetish,
say this.
We're making fetish porn.
By the,
it's worse. It's fucked.
No.
It's worse.
It's fucked up. It's
all right,
worse.
Let's say this. Nico, if we do this, and I don't know if it's up to Fez, But this fucking Freddy has to come in as the third man. And he has to leave his socks on.
That's
like
fine.
This other fucking kid.
That's fine.
And jockey shorts. There's no fucking boxers being worn.
Right.
Tidy whities.
And there has to be some kind of thing on there that these three gay guys, it has to be something said, this is no joke. These fucking guys are like this.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay. I could just really kiss any ESPN career goodbye.
I would have no problem
this point.
If you say that this is too lame. Because it's not. I've seen worse stunts have to go down. But
if you know Pepper, I think this is really, really bad.
I do know Pepper. And I fucking treat the kid like gold. That's why I don't make him stunt around like he's a fucking moron like the rest of you.
Yep.
I think the kid's a fucking person.
I'm a person.
But I could see Fez being as open-minded as Fez is.
Right.
He might not see this as very horrifying.
It seems pretty natural to rub your beard on somebody.
What?
This is horrifying.
Fuck, look at this shit.
This is scary.
Like I said, there's no kissing going on even.
Doesn't have to be. It's a fetish. This is a dark fucking recess of the internet that we're fucking crawling into, and I'm betting on this fucking asshole, Freddy, to beat Nico.
Freddy's a fucking moron.
He's got and this. I trust him.
And it's timely because if we a lot do of people this, are playing this stuff.
Like Ron said, if we do this, you know, the caption is on there, this is real, and it goes out beyond 202 Friends. It gets released to some porn sites.
Sure.
Fuck yeah. No problem.
Sure. I'll do that. So and I'll kiss all any future. Yeah. Goodbye. But I'll do it because that's how much I believe in Mr. 250. Destiny turns on the radio. That's Freddy. That's who I believe in.
I don't know why you do. I don't know what the fuck ever made you like this kid.
Five quarters.
Because he's got nothing.
Five quarters is all.
And then to sit there wincing as I'm telling the story where all he had to do was go running over the little redhead girl. Shit, give me a dollar for these quarters. Fucking Bennington is going to kill me on the air for this.
Take it out of the wallet.
Whatever he has to
he's
do.
Got a dollar.
Just to keep from being the guy handing back fucking silver.
He didn't even think, no, he's too late now.
Well, it will be up to Fez Watley. Fez Watley, do you accept this challenge or do you think you got a problem? It's either a yes or no, because I don't want to spend all day with these assholes.
Right. I am going to accept this
challenge. Wow, $1,000 challenge.
I will accept this.
All right, now let me work it out with the guys. Is it one game? Is it a three-game series? What you guys think? Pick.
Three games sounds good to me.
Now, how does the three-game series? Is it the best out of three games, or is it the total number of pins? I don't know how the betting takes place in bowling.
Well, we could do series. Best series.
Want to do the total number of pins?
Yeah, sure, whatever.
Total number of pins. Is that the way people normally bet in bowling? Because I'm going to have to fucking ask some real fucking bowlers how this is done. You know?
Yeah, it would seem to be two out of three.
To me,
games.
I would two out
or
of three
just
games.
One game. Yeah. It would seem it's either sudden death one game or two out of three games. Because in the World Series, you know, if a team wins 11-0, but they drop next one 1-0, that's not how they do it in other sports.
No, I don't want to hear any fucking shit about I need my own ball or any of this. Okay, because the fact of the matter is, we roll today.
Oh. Nice.
We walk out of here, and we roll today.
Okay.
Is that too scary for you, Nico?
No, not at all.
Freddy, is that too scary for you?
Let's do it.
He's second-guessing himself.
You should be.
You got this, Fred.
Oh, God is my witness, I hope.
You got it.
I got it.
Otherwise, get some tidy whities.
You say you hope? You definitely have this, motherfucker. Come on.
Relax, Pepper. This is my man. He's got it.
Relax, jockey shorts. Don't even fucking worry about a thing.
Just chill.
By the way, this fucking beard nuzzling thing has been going on now for how long? It's fucking five. We gotta be 6-7 minutes in. And here's what I don't understand.
The one guy left.
Neither one of them even has wood. They're not fucking turned on by this. They're bored to death.
It's good.
Where did you guys find this?
This is everywhere. This is like the new rage.
Here's Brandon in Illinois. You're on Running Fest. Oh, God, belly rubbing.
Nice.
Brandon, go ahead.
Yeah, that's what I had to ask Dave. He might want to reconsider doing this in tidy whities. He's not going to be able to hide his heart on.
He can't even show off his heart on in tidy whities. We've been through it before.
No, we haven't. I'm a grower, not a shower. I can grow a very large 6-inch erection. very large.
Prove it. Prove it.
I can't give a hard. This is not fun for me. I never want to see Pepper with his fucking shirt off.
This is a 7-minute fucking gimmick.
This is fucked, man.
It goes on and on.
You're back in a fucking loser.
I'm not worried.
No. Freddy, stay confident. Look at me. You are a fucking choke artist, and everyone's going to fucking know it.
Freddy, just stay confident, pal. Don't let him get into your head.
Nico's as calm as can be.
He's a real deal.
He's ready to go.
My God, he's gonna get the old pilly who can't fucking control himself without his pills, Nico. Yeah, crush up some fucking Adderall, keep it together.
So what? He fucking rolls and he fucking rolls. That's him. He's an ecstasy guy.
I like life.
Dave, scale 1 to 10. How fucking nervous are you?
Can I say 0? Yeah. With Freddy?
Mm-hmm.
I think Freddy's going to win this. I think Nico's coming in the way he came into that bowling night a couple years ago, overconfident and embarrassing.
I'm telling you right now, I think you can win this thing with a 90. Yeah. I really do.
So wait, we have to sell. Is it 2 out of 3? It's 2 out of 3 games, right?
Let's fucking...
Or is it just sudden death one game?
Why are we going to have all these fucking rules?
All right, forget about the other rules. Can I drink beer?
You know it's not a Friday right now. All right, Fez and I have a meeting, and then we're going for that meeting. The Port Authority has some open fucking lanes, and we're going straight to it.
Oh, at the Port Authority? This is fucking
convenient.
That's
right, I saw that there.
So now I really can drink.
That's yes. Where I crashed my last party.
I don't even
party.
Have to fucking do anything.
That's perfect. That's where he crashed last time, Alki. You don't even fucking remember.
That's right. I forgot. Oh, boy, Freddy. I am very excited. I love
me
competition.
Too. This is intense. I'm excited about this. I'm ready for it, too.
And none of this fucking warming up bullshit. Yeah. We're just going, and we're going to fucking roll.
That's cool. I like that idea.
May the best man win.
I gotta talk to some people who know how the fucking rules of this, because I want to set it up properly.
Okay.
And this is going to surprise you. Not a big fucking bowler here.
Okay, I get
so
it.
I don't know how this fucking works out.
Well, you're not going to enjoy today at all.
Well, I like a bet. I'm not going to lie about that. I fucking enjoy the fact of this. And this is the first time that fucking Pepper's ever had that sword over top of his neck.
Yeah. He's never had it.
Adam, you're on the Run and Face show.
Hey, guys. Man, the only way you can do this is 3 games, total pins. The lane itself throws so many variables at you. Your first game is basically warming up all in itself. It's 3 games, total pins.
And that's the way, let's suppose, if one of them was a hustler going to the alley looking for a game, you'd play 3 games, total pins?
Absolutely.
Okay. All right, so that's the first idea out there. Either one of you guys have a problem with that. So you could even find yourself down by 40, 50 pins after 2 games and hit one of your famous fucking comebacks.
Yeah.
But then that
on.
Stops the game itself from having any excitement factor.
Maybe, but it does make it, you have to play all 3 games. So that kind of makes it exciting, I guess. I just never
heard
that.
Yeah, I get that. You do have to play all 3.
You know.
Ed in Hartford, you're on Run and Fez.
Hey, what's up, guys? I was just wondering how long this video is going to have to be when that piece of shit Freddy fucking blows it.
This video seems to go on forever.
I know. It's fucking basically the longest film I've... Lawrence of Arabia.
And this is a part 2, it says.
No
well, yeah, you get a chance to go out and smoke.
I wonder which one's going to be which. Pepper's going to have his arms behind his head with his eyes closed, feeling all happy while I do the majority of the work.
Works for me.
I guess my beard is longer than Pepper's, so I probably should be the nuzzle instigator.
Yeah, you should be.
Right.
You're saying Pepper's the bottom.
You're going to lose, fucker. You better enjoy your laughter right
He's
now.
So calm and confident. I love Nico.
Well, I'll tell you something else. This is fucking Freddy's confident, too. Look at him.
Yeah. I'm ready. I said, let's do it.
Sounded convincing there. Let's do it.
We're going to the Port Authority pretty much after the show today. Fezzy and I have a fast meeting, and then we're fucking out of here and laying this thing down. And I want to put together something else that I just recently found out. This is the big surprise happy bowling birthday party for Fez Watley. Fez Watley, 64 years old today. Every summer, Fez will go. You don't know any of the lyrics.
Something
you don't know.
Summertime and
it's Fez Watley's big bowling party, and of course, just like every year, he has two young men do stuff for him, and it ends up in a nuzzle party afterwards.
Bowling and beard porn. This is the best.
It is going to be the best.
I'm very excited.
That's what he was wearing. It's all like, what are you doing, hand?
Oh, you didn't see the new one, did you?
They're all so annoying.
I thought I was watching it here with the beard porn.
By the way, do you guys have hairy backs enough to do this beard porn? Because these guys have disgusting backs.
I have a hairy fart patch that's on just, on the small of your back.
Okay, let me take a look at it. I didn't know that was called a
fart.
That's
the best we can get.
Yeah, I don't see a single hair there.
No, there's hair right all over here. See, I'm pulling at it.
Red hair. Nobody can see that.
Yeah, that's not going to show up on camera.
Oh, it shows.
We can do the white balance, though.
It shows.
And I've got $1,000 for Eastside Dave and Chris Stanley if their guy Fast Freddy wins. If our guy, me and Ronnie, if our guy Nico wins,
that's right.
Then oh, it's Tidy Whitey beard porn between Chris Stanley, Eastside Dave, and their bowler, Fast Freddy.
Wow. Wow.
Now, if do win, do I get a cut of the $1,000?
You got to go ask your boys.
You got to talk to your
sponsors.
If I was
you, if I didn't, I'd fucking tank this thing if I was you.
No, we're going to give you something.
If I didn't get half, I'd tank this fucking
thing. We'll give you something.
Okay.
But I'll tell you this. If you lose, they're going to beat your ass. They're never going to stop hitting you.
Right, you're going to get
something. They're going to have really rough beards.
Here's the problem. When something goes out on the internet, it's never gone.
Oh, no, it's forever.
So any idea you have, someday I'll be a program director, forget that. That's all out.
Yeah, it's over.
Freddy's got it.
Tidy Whitey's and bowling. I don't know what the hell has happened to us.
Best birthday ever.
I tell you what. After today, people are going to be saying Freddy got fingered. That's what they're going to be saying, because that's how good he's going to bowl.
The interesting thing is, you're the only person who knows that reference.
Tom Green's awesome.
Tom Green put that movie out of his own mind. He doesn't even want to think about it.
Rip torn.
Here's David, Jacksonville.
Hey, Ronnie.
Yeah.
Hey, that's a lot of cabbage fed that he's putting up. I think maybe to sweeten the deal on the other side, if Fat
No,
Freddy,
we're not going
to
fucking play any of that. We just have a deal now.
Yeah, okay?
We just have a deal. The one reason that I hate betting is that it goes back, well, I never get to do this. That's why I don't want, neither one of these cocksucks gets to go home and practice.
That's
We're
good.
Just going to go down there and roll. Maybe they won't have their best game. So what?
Why are you always looking at Freddy when you say that? This is very upsetting. Freddy needs a blindfold.
What's funny about Fez handing a Jibo away?
Nothing to
nothing.
Me.
Nothing.
Freddy wins. He wins.
I know Freddy's a liar, though, and that's the fucking part that annoyed me. This is all because Freddy came on my show and started lying. Let's go over to Matt in Virginia.
Hey, Ron, I just wanted to say, I think it's important that if Pepper loses, he has to act like he's enjoying it.
I don't know if I can guarantee that.
Yeah, I mean,
not a method actor.
Here's the fucking deal. It's got to look like one of these fucking things, one of these fetish bits.
Yeah, we're going to.
It can't be like, oh, God, I can't believe we're doing this, or we lost the bet. You just fucking do it and know that some weird old guy in Milwaukee's jacking off to the two of you. You're looking forward to this, Dave.
I'm not looking forward to it at all,
You
honestly.
Want fucking Freddy to tank.
I do not want to be that close to Pepper's chest.
And I'm going
to
send it to Tony Reality.
No, don't do that.
I'm going to send it to Pepper's in-laws and just say special Seder video.
Trust me, if you tell Tony, he'd probably want to join in.
I have this under control. I will win.
And
we could bowl for the next 72 hours straight. You're not going to hit 250 pins altogether.
Fez, what could be a better birthday than bowling at the Port Authority, loser gets in their underwear, and rubs each other?
It's heaven.
Yeah.
It's the best.
We better send someone out for the tidy whities pretty
soon.
Send Jackie out for the underwear.
Craig and I, well, you're on Running Fez.
Happy birthday, yo, man. Hey, it sounds like Fezzy doesn't lose either way on this thing.
He gets Fez is a big winner today.
I'm getting a birthday party.
Yeah. Fez gets a bowling party just like when he was 11.
Those are always the best, though.
Yeah.
There was no better theme party for kids than the bowling party. Fuck pool party, in my opinion. Fuck the arcade. I love bowling the best.
They did a thing in our town in the winter, right, that they had to have the town somehow paid for the lanes. So if you were, like, 12 and under, you could bowl for free as part of, like, the recreation thing.
That's awesome.
It was almost having a gym. We went there every fucking Sunday like a nightmare. Three guys bowling in the same lane together. Waiting for the fucking gate to come down so you could try to hit that. Taking the ball and just smashing in. Fucking always we'd be thrown out. And we always left there wearing the shoes. See you fuckers. It was fucking hysterical. I don't know what the hope was. I guess the township fucking paid him some money. But we know we were never going to make it. Yeah. Keep them out of trouble. They're over there fucking throwing 10-pound balls at each other.
They're just transferring the trouble into the bowling alley.
Well, you know, if you want to hang out at the Conchester Bolero, some fucking beautiful things are going to happen for you. Here's Charlie. You're on Ronnie Fez.
Ronnie, do you know how disappointing this is for Pepper Hicks fans? You know there's no picture of him online. He's like the coolest son of a bitch. So to hear that he's going to take part in this, this breaks my heart, sir.
It breaks my heart, too, because I always had him in the back of my mind as the next Ronnie B. And now I see that that doesn't matter to him.
Well, he put it out, he's doing this because he believes, as do I, that Freddie is going to win this thing.
Freddie's a fucking mongoloid.
Freddie can thunder.
What's he going to do, bowl overhand?
I'll do anything to win.
Anything.
And that type of charisma makes me believe that he's going to take this thing. I'll do anything to win.
You going to buy everybody matching bowling shirts now?
Yeah, I wish I knew. I would have brought my bowling shirt with me.
Whoa.
You have a bowling shirt?
Yeah.
I bet all your fucking shirts are bowling shirts.
You're wearing them you're wearing them to fucking funerals.
I have a 250 pin. Like right here.
Let's go over here to Albert in El Paso.
Hey, Dave. I know that you probably do believe in Freddy's 298. It probably happened the day right after you shot your hole-in-one, right?
Oh, yeah, Dave. You said you had a hole-in-one that time?
Yes. I got a hole-in-one.
Bullshit.
I don't believe
it,
buddy.
Get a hole-in-one.
All right, yes, and again, no, like, Freddie, there's no proof here. We're just going by someone's word for it. There's no documentation, any of it.
Oh, look who it is. It's Jesus. Jesus, you're on Ronnie Fez.
Let me tell you something, Bendejo. You pull your shit out on the, you shoot your gun out on the lane, I pull it up your trick, and I pull the trigger till it go click. Nobody fuck with the Jesus, man.
He's a pederast. He's a pederast, dude. We'll take a break. When we get back, we'll tell you how you can get the updates on the $1,000 versus beard-rubbing, gay, fetish, porn, bowling contest. Fez Wiley's birthday. Bill in Boston, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Radio legend, say what?
What?
I want to blow it for Fezzy today. You ready?
Yeah, blow for Fez. Blowing for Fez Wiley today on his big birthday. 866-RUN-0-FEZ. 866-RUN-0-FEZ. I remember last year, Fezzy, you ran the phones and you took the calls for your birthday.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I didn't feel like doing that this year.
Had a lot of fun, though, did you?
Last year or this year?
I don't know what to tell you. Just trying to say happy birthday to you, pal, and hoping that you're enjoying yourself bowling today. Bowling for dollars or donuts. You look over at Chris Stanley, first time ever putting himself out there as a freak.
I have utmost confidence in Freddie, and I could use that cash.
You were my special girl for a long time. I didn't have to worry about you being part of the clown circus.
And I won't be. Don't worry. It's a one-time special.
Freddie's a fucking loser.
He's going to fucking run this bowling alley. Nico's a fucking train wreck of a human being.
Well,
I can't fight that.
You know, we've been so focused on what a fuck-up Freddie is. And there ain't going to be any yelling and heckling. Let these fucking kids roll.
That's fine.
It is a big April 1. Yesterday, of course, Fez Watley's birthday. And once again, the kid pulls it off. You are lately on a win streak that can't be beat. We sat in here yesterday and we heard from Fast Freddy that he had a 250 bowling average. I yelled bullshit at him. You're an asshole. You're a liar. He was as serious can be. I understand sometimes people listen to the show and they're like, what is real? It's like wrestling. I don't understand. The fucking kid said that he rolled a 250 average. Impossible. I called him out. As usual, his little backups, Chris Stanley and fucking Eastside Dave, the Rube of Rubes, said they will back him up. Fez put up $1,000. The guys said, if he doesn't beat Nico, this fucking idiot kid, this Fast Freddy, that they would do something called beard porn, which I'd never even heard of before. Ridiculous. We go out to roll. And like everybody else, we bowl at the bus station. That's the only fucking way you're going to go down. So we go over to the bus station. The kid, the 250 average that he has, Fez, the first game, what exactly did he roll?
Fast Freddy's first game, an 85, Ron.
An 85! One-third of what he claimed he could do. What did your guy Nico do?
Nico beat him with a 134.
Yeah. The second game, Fast Freddy back up on top, rolls a what, Fez?
A 121.
121. Your guy decides to tank the last frame and leaves it 121 to 121. Now they need the last game to pull out some kind of a tie for themselves. Fast Freddy knows that these two guys that back him 100% will have to do online beard porn. What did he roll for them?
He rolled for them a 109.
A 109. Your guy, Nico?
126.
126. So basically, we wasted Fez's birthday watching two girls bowl. Chris Stanley, why would you back this Fast Freddy kid?
Yeah, lesson learned on it wasn't so much I was backing Fast Freddy. I guess I was thinking that lack of faith in Nico. I figured
no.
The case.
I don't believe that.
Mess.
I don't believe that because Nico was never. It didn't matter whether it was Nico. Didn't matter if we went over to fucking the hip hop station and grabbed somebody there, somebody off the oldies. Didn't matter. This fucking choke artist. And I didn't even get in his kitchen, Fez. If I would have started to fuck with him, he would have bowled 40. I just let him go.
And he was a swinging mess out there.
Sweating, literally gacking himself.
Apparently he didn't have his ball. That was the, that's what
yeah, everybody always has that fucking excuse.
Muttering to me in between frames.
Yeah. I remember the guy who always says, this isn't my real glove. Normally I can fucking catch everything. I get it.
Laces out, I guess.
Don't mind seeing Eastside Dave become the fucking Rube. It pains me to see that happen to you, though.
Pains me, too. This is a bad decision. Bad decision to back, Fast Freddy.
Not I hope you make the rest of his fucking internship a nightmare. He's a piece of shit. He's not as good as Fez or whatever the stuff that Fez screamed at him. It's all fucking... See, this is the way you win things, Fez. You don't sit and scream and cry and all that. You just say, put it on the line, pal. Put it on the line.
$1,000 of my own cash money I had on the line. If Fez Freddy had maybe shown up for them... They'd be swimming in cash today.
Mm.
Now, it's
quick,
beard porn.
Five honey apiece. I'd never heard of beard porn, by the way, until yesterday.
I had no idea this was out there.
It's all over the place. It's a sensation of gay.
Because you're the one person that should know there is such a thing. That's what hurts me. Eastside Dave?
Kid had a bad day, Ronnie.
Kid had a bad life. That's the fucking thing you don't understand.
He had
this was
day.
Not an aberration.
I think he had an off day. I take Freddie over Pete Weber any day.
I'm glad that it's funny to you because you have no self-worth. But this fucking kid, Hicks, Chris Stanley, had made some... I'm going to read a little email because we do get emails.
And now, Ron and Fez, the show of the future, brings you...
Electronic mail. Mail sent electronically.
This says, Ronnie, Chris Stanley never did something stupid like this before. That is why I love Chris Stanley. He is not a stupid pet trick, Eastside Dave. This is a very sad day for Pepper Hicks fans to see him become a monkey. I gotta agree.
Sad day for me too there, emailer.
This is one I'm not sure you can come back from, Beardport.
It's pretty bad. I'm not looking forward to this.
I don't get it. I fucking seriously, don't ever make yourself look like a dick if you can help it. And Chris Stanley, you did. You did.
Oh yeah, big time. I feel like I look like an asshole right now.
No, not yet. You will when this thing gets YouTubed.
Yeah.
When you and Dave are rubbing faces against each other.
And you were told that this Fast Freddy was a sham.
Yeah, and don't forget, Freddy actually has to enter the video as well.
Why are you so happy with it, Dave?
I'm not happy.
Why are you so happy you pulled down my Chris Stanley to your level?
Dave, stop reminding them about this. Oh. I'm not, I'm pissed.
Oh, Dave, Paulie Loosebells has something to tell you.
Okay.
I think there was a
what
call
the
for you.
Fuck? My kid's in the hospital.
Oh, okay. Well,
apparently.
You gotta,
I gotta run.
No. You gotta stay or you're fired.
He told me that my kid's in the hospital.
You gotta stay or you're fired. That's the deal. Best day ever. This is the best day ever.
What were you just whispering there?
Nothing. I was just saying.
Okay. So, my kid's in the hospital.
So, whatever. Let's not make a big deal out of it. A little later on, we're going to bring the kid into the show that choked on Dave and Hicks, and the reason why you guys are putting out your own beard porn.
Yes, Fast Freddy the intern is in the house, as they say, 1989.
Now, me being involved in a beard porn thing that was released to the internet, to me, that's the fucking nightmare. You seem to be okay with that, though, Dave.
I mean...
You can't be embarrassed.
I am laughing... Because I feel bad for my friend, Pepper. That's why I'm laughing. It's because I'm laughing at his pain. If I had to do this by myself, I'd be very upset. But I don't know. It's kind of funny to see Pepper so upset about this.
I don't think you can do solo beard porn.
By the way, I hate that Hicks is going to be doing this. It really bothers me. It annoys me.
I know. It's upsetting.
And I want to pull him off of it and make Fez do it because Fez doesn't give a shit. But then what does that teach him about betting? I don't know what to do.
Yeah, there has to be some kind of punishment.
Maybe there doesn't.
No, there doesn't. I agree with that. No, if he gets pulled off,
thinking about pulling him off of it. Because in my heart, I owe this fucking kid. I owe Fez, obviously, nothing. I owe Dave nothing.
Oh, come on.
But
no
Chris
way.
Stanley, I owe.
We did this as a team.
I know. And I'm thinking about just breaking all the rules. And cheating and letting Chris out of it.
Well, then, if you get a substitute, I'm going to get my own sub. I'll fucking get Paulie Loosebells in there.
You are the sub.
So it'll be Fez and Paulie fucking Loosebells.
And Freddy will still be the third man interrupting.
Just so you know, you came up with this, but you can't even let Chris out of it now. That's how fucking awful you are.
No, yeah, exactly.
He didn't want to be in on this.
He can let me out. No way, Jose. San Jose Sharks.
It's unbelievable. Just so you know that, Ix.
It's nothing. It's two guys make a bet that they're
why do you care whether you're doing it with Hicks or Fez? What does it matter to you?
Because it's not fair to me. Then
you're not fucking fair.
I shouldn't be punished.
It's fair to you.
I shouldn't be punished if he's not punished, is my point.
I just feel like you guys are destroying his character. That he wasn't one of the radio bozos. He wasn't one of the stunt losers.
I know.
He was a fucking regular guy. And
he
now
was.
You pulled him down to your levels. We might as well fucking change his name to Eastside Fez. It's so embarrassing.
Well, I thought I was out of the stunt game, so this is actually bringing me back in.
You came up with the stunt idea.
I didn't have any other thoughts.
You guys could have said, shave my head, blah, 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 whatever. Fez wasn't going to lose this bet. You two tanked on a fucking idiot.
We believed in Freddy. That's why we're upset.
You backed him up.
I'm telling you, the fact that you believe in Freddy makes you both bad producers.
I don't make eye contact with him anymore. I'm just sickened.
You're sickened because of all that James Beam you drank last night. That's why you're sickened.
So what? He's an alcoholic.
It was Johnny Walker, actually. Classy.
What was the occasion? Easter?
It was Sunday, and Lent was over.
Oh, that's right. What time did you start drinking?
3 a.m. on Saturday. I chugged a beer and passed out. I didn't even get drunk. I just, like, I can drink now. I chugged it and just passed out.
So you kept everything going?
Yeah, I made it. I made it to fucking whatever. I made it to the whole
40 days. Lent.
Yeah.
Nice.
Nothing. My Collins has gone down like a motherfucker, though. I got lit up yesterday. I had not that much booze.
That's embarrassing. So, now, were you drinking alone?
I was watching the end game with some people. I was the only one drinking.
Were they at your house or were you out at a bar?
I was at a buddy's place. And I called them pussies and just kept drinking by myself.
Yeah, well, if they're hanging out with you, they are pussies. No matter what they're doing. Those guys could be chopping up a hooker. They're still pussies.
Sounds like you squeezed 40 days in 24 hours.
He said he only
Davey Mack, let him out of this.
Let him out?
Yeah.
Let him out, and then I still have to be punished.
You do it with Fez.
This seems unfair to me.
This isn't about fairness. It's about protecting the show for once. For once in your life,
I always
of the
protect
show.
The show. I always think of the show first.
All right. There you go, Chris Stanley. I want you to know, this fucking guy who you stick up for all the time is fucking foot dragging.
Yeah, he fucks me.
Because Fez don't like the idea any better, but he's staying quiet. Like somebody who cares.
He'll do beard porn?
Without fucking thinking about it.
$20 in for you, David Mack.
Well, wait a second. If I get paid...
See, that's fucking embarrassing.
$20?
Now, you know what?
He shouldn't have
no,
to do that.
All three of you are doing beard porn and licking each other's fucking ass cracks. That's what you get for being pricks. All right, we're taking a break here. When we get back, we are going to have the kid explaining why he is such a big liar. This is this idiot, Fast Freddy, who... Actually, if you look at this, they're costing $1,000 embarrassment to Chris Stanley and, of course, Eastside Dave. And why did you guys believe in this idiot?
Don't know anymore. I'm just sickened.
He lied to us on the air, and I've got a big problem with that. He lied about his 250 average. Whether or not he brought you guys down, which is funny, he still lied right to my face. I want to talk to him about it. It's the Ron and Fez show. Send me in the intern, would you please? Our intern told us last week that he had a 250 bowling average. Fez, read off his scores, please.
In the first game, Fast Freddy the intern bowled an 85. In the second game, he bowled a 121. In the third game, a 109.
Which made his three-game average what, Fez?
105.
105. Now, Freddy.
Yeah.
Not only were you not a good bowler, it seemed like you had very little idea how the game of bowling is actually played. You put no English on the ball whatsoever. You just threw down as hard as you possibly could every single time, bringing the ball to the floor with a loud thud. There's no finesse to your game whatsoever.
No, I didn't realize I was dropping the ball. And that's because the ball wasn't fitting properly into my hand. It was either too big or too small.
I'm going to give you something else here. Mm-hmm. You have zero idea how to pick up a spare.
Yeah, I need to work on the spare game a little bit.
You told us you had a 250 average.
Right.
There's no way in seeing you that you've ever rolled 250 once ever in your fucking life.
You know, the 250 average may have been a little much.
Why would you lie to him? Why would you sit here and lie to me? And I don't care that you got Dave and fucking Pepper doing this thing, but why would you lie to me? Why would you come on this show and start lying?
You know, I was just trying to, you know, act like I, you know, could do a really good game. And I've shot, like, in the 200s or whatever, but I should have come up with a different number because...
Why not just tell the truth? What kept you from telling the truth?
I don't know.
If you would have came in here and said, I'm a guy who at one time rolled 201, we wouldn't have any of these problems.
Yeah.
You told us you have a 250 average.
I know. It is a little ridiculous. My average used to be about like a 180.
You never kept an average in your life. You don't know what an average is. But you saying anything to me now is a lie. Anything. There's no way your average was 180. You don't have the skills.
Well, I do apologize for lying about my average. I definitely had my worst games.
There's no way to know that. There was no, at no point did you look like you understood how to pick up any kind of a spare. I will admit, your little jackhammer, you kicked the fucking pins out, but it's still just a straight line. There's no hook to the ball. There's no English. There's no spin. There's nothing.
Yeah.
And I'm not a guy who's spent enough time around bowlers to know, but any bowler I've seen fucking bowls incredibly different than you do. You bowl like any of us who show up and bowl once a decade. It's the exact style that you have, the exact way you act. You don't look like a guy who's familiar with it. Hicks, how long before you know you're in trouble?
First, really, my first ball. When he hit, one pin, I think, was his fucking one nail.
Yeah, first time he came out, he hit one fucking pin. And I said to you, if he leaves the first frame open, you're in fucking trouble because he's been lying the whole time.
Maybe before that, I knew it's not looking good when he said he couldn't find his ball. That really upset me very much.
And you were exhausting yourself. The 16-pound ball was too heavy for you.
I was stressing out. I was nervous.
You were sweating.
I was sweating profusely, yeah. I just wasn't feeling good about it from the beginning, you know? I just didn't have a good feeling about how I was
going to
do.
You knew that you lied and couldn't back it up.
Well, I did know that my average wasn't 250. I didn't think I was going to do as bad as I did, though. I was hoping to at least, get like a 150, 180 something, at least.
Well, if you would have got a 150, a 180, those guys would have $1,000. I'd call you a liar, and they go, what do we care? We just spent the money, and they would be happy.
I know.
What did he have to beat?
Was it 134, 121, or 126?
Not talking about a lot there.
No. We did tie the second game.
He tanked it for you to keep us paying attention to him.
Yeah, I will admit I did horrible.
Never in my mind were you playing against Nico. You were playing against 250. Period. Because Nico came in here and didn't say a goddamn thing. Yeah. He goes, I can beat this idiot.
And he did. It was not a good day for me. That's for sure.
You're not going to be doing beard porn like Pepper Hicks. Now, Chris Stanley, I will tell you this. Someone has written to us that I would say is probably one of Fez's best radio friends. And that, of course, is Kathleen from the Bronx. And she's saying, free Chris Stanley. Put Fez in there. We need Chris as the cool guy. You would have had that if it wasn't for Dave kicking up his heels.
Yeah, Dave's a scumbag, and I'm just fucking defeated, pretty much. I don't feel good about myself.
You ruined your rep. Yeah. Thanks. You destroyed your rep. You've got the same
pledge
rep.
For Chris.
You're a fucking idiot. What's that?
I'd like to pledge for Chris and, have him not have to partake in this because...
I don't need you to talk for me there.
I feel bad because it was my fault. I
You need to go over there and sell that fucking story to Dave.
I'll do my best. I really feel guilty over the whole thing.
You are guilty. That's why you feel that way. You lied. They believed you. I didn't.
I know.
After the game, Freddy still maintained that he had shot a 298 once.
You're a liar.
That is the truth. I'm honest to
there
God.
There is
the,
no
the
way.
Truth.
It didn't take place in real life.
No.
We watched you. You have zero skills, Freddy. Zero.
Can we do it again? Like if I have my, own ball
absolutely
and
not.
Stuff like that?
No. Absolutely not. It was dull. It started off like the first couple minutes. We're like, this is so much fun. By the third game, we were all bored shitless. Watching you waste our time. Yeah, you're an awful kid. You're an awful kid and there's no way around it.
Yeah, I did. I did do horrible bowling Wednesday. It was
all right.
Horribly,
yes.
Now there's enough people saying, "Don't let Pepper off the hook," or you're just enabling his gambling. So what? I can't enable him. enable the other ones. I'm not the fucking perfect daddy ever. I haven't enabled Fez over the years. Jason in Wisconsin, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey there, boys. And I don't think Freddie was lying to you guys. My daughter's 12, and she's a solid deuce, and I have bowler on Wii Sports.
See, Wii Sports makes a little more sense.
I've also hit a 475-foot home run on Wii Home Run Derby.
Too bad this bet wasn't done on the Wii.
Emails, we do get emails.
And now, Ron and Fez, the show of the future, brings you...
Electronic mail. Mail sent electronically.
This one said, where is beard porn, or did I miss it? You did not miss beard porn.
No.
Beard porn goes down today.
Okay.
We are taping it today.
Good. I've been wanting to tape it, and people are giving Davey Mac the runaround.
Is there any way Dave can still let me out of this at all?
Pepper?
Yes.
People are giving me the runaround. I'm like, every day, let's tape it. I got stuff to do. This guy can't be here. I'm glad we're doing it today, then.
You are glad to do it today?
Yeah.
Now, how exactly does beard porn work?
Well, the two gentlemen involved are very romantically rubbing their beards on each other. There's no sex. There's no dick sucking, as it were.
Oh, I didn't know. Dick sucking. Okay.
And they're sitting there in their T-shirts and underwear, preferably whitey tighties, in order to just rub their beards in a loving way.
Mm.
It's the big rage that's going on all over the Internet.
Beard porn will go up, and of course we'll put this up on 202 Friends on Twitter, and then everyone's free to retweet or take to websites. Do whatever you will with it. Now, what are we going to be shooting it with?
We have, I have my very good camera here that's on my phone.
Mm-hmm.
And that, if it goes longer than 40 seconds, I'll go home and take it from my phone, put it on the computer to 202 Friends.
Well, the one you showed me went 16 minutes.
Yeah. If it goes less than 40 seconds, then we can put it up instantly. Mm-hmm. Or if we want to take our time, no problem.
Now,
just
against your beard, pretend the beard was the other person. How does beard porn work?
You just, like, caress the person. And just rub it ever so nice. Just rub your beard on each other. That feels good.
You're excited, huh?
Doesn't sound like it.
Yeah.
Sounds rough.
You're excited about it.
Well, I brought up. It didn't leave Davey Mack's mind, but then, you know, it seems like people were trying to avoid. I'm like, come on, you know, a bet's a bet. Let's do it.
A bet is a bet. There's no getting around it. We need some kind of music to this.
Yeah, okay. We can do that. We can do that. If we did it in the studio, we could probably, you know, we'll fill around. We could probably play it.
What is music that you think would work for this?
Oh, a very soft kind of something sexy. Lionel Richie. I don't know. Something sexy.
So you want to go back to the 80s, obviously.
Barry White. I don't know.
A Barry White, a Lionel Richie. What was the song that Luke raped Laura to? That was a gigantic big rape song that people loved back in the 80s. I would also like to do something where we give out your full names and addresses.
Oh, come on.
In case anybody's really into it.
No, you can't do that. Luke rapes Lord. No, I don't want my name and address out
there. It was Rise by Herb Alpert.
All right, let's take a little listen to Rise. Yeah, this is sexy. It's got to start right from there.
That's where the beards come in.
There's definitely got to be a top and a bottom to this, though.
Either way, I'm cool with whatever spot I play. Just doing what's good for the team.
Yeah, somebody wrote in, you know, there are no beards, there are no t-shirts in beard porn. Well, the obviously. Ones, the ones, obviously.
Okay, I mean, the videos we pulled up had the guys in t-shirts. Yeah.
God, what are you waiting for? This is perfect. Now, I'm a little disappointed with only 40 seconds.
Well, if we want to go more, that's cool. We will. But then I'll have to go home in order to put it up. But we can go as long as we want.
Can we do part one, part two, part three, part four?
Sure, we could do it like that.
All right.
Different stages of undress.
We got enough light in here, or we need more light?
No, we have a light because there's a light on my camera.
So we need to get it over here.
Yeah.
On the porch. Up.
Put the lights up as much as possible.
Can Pepper, you up for this? You ready to go with it?
Did Dave still have the option of letting me out? Is that still on the table? I'm just listening
Dave,
to music.
Are you ready for this thing?
Yeah, I am.
Fezzy, you ready for this?
I'm ready for it.
No, oh. The beauty of it is, I like to see myself as director and producer of
okay.
this beard porn.
We can use, we have a cameraman too.
Who's the cameraman?
Well, we have one of our former interns.
Who's that?
Darren.
I'll bring Darren in. Because I want to talk things over before.
He actually does study film and stuff.
Oh,
storyboard.
Well, great. I want to see what he wants to do with these shots. Because we agreed we need a part one, part two, part three, and they should be all a little different. Darren. First of all, welcome and thanks. I don't know what I'd do without you right
thanks.
Now.
Thanks. Always a pleasure.
It's great to meet my DP. Now, how do you see this? I see it on the couch over here in the corner.
Yeah, I think the couch is going to work. The lighting is a little better over on the couch for Dave's skin.
Right.
Because, you know, his skin's going to be kind of a problem.
Now, what do you think of this music, by the way?
This is going to be
it's pretty sexy, right?
Yeah.
And I think
Dave's already dancing.
Dave can't stop moving.
That's a really kind of cool music.
Dave, let's get you over on the couch right now so we can do some blocking shots.
Okay.
Yeah, let's get you out of that shirt.
Wait. What are you doing?
Just lay down. Lay down. And what I'd like to see is, like, it kind of starts as we're just looking at Dave.
Yeah.
And then, of course, Pepper's going to climb up and come straight up his belly.
Oh, that's awesome.
Into the chin to chin. Yeah.
I'm really in charge here.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah, you are.
That's
you're
awesome.
Going to be the stud.
No, I deserve to be in charge. I wanted to film this yeah. for a fucking week and a half.
I know.
It's like at your house.
Like, I got to catch a plane or something.
You got and kind of look like you're roofied up, Dave. I want there
oh,
to be
yeah.
a backstory.
That's not too hard. Yeah. I can get into a very roofy mentality.
Now,
quick.
I don't know everything that you have, but
can
we do a crane shot at all?
May I ask you a couple questions?
Yeah.
Can I have, like, a shot of vodka, like, before we film this?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
I won't have any other way. Go get it now, because we're going to start shooting in a minute. Yes.
That may not have time to take effect.
Go quickly. Two
I'll
shots.
Just tell Jackie to get
it. Yeah. Jackie, run up and get the vodka. And I noticed that the little red-haired girl is not wearing pants again today.
No, she's not.
Those are not pants.
Now, remember yesterday when I brought up the fact that my guest had a couple of pops?
Mm-hmm.
It was recommended to him by the little red-haired girl who said, I don't know what he meets her out front. I don't know whether to go have a couple of drinks or a cup of coffee because he was a little bit nervous about it. She recommended drinks. You study film where, Darren?
At the illustrious Brookdale Community College.
All right, Brookdale Community College.
I attended there.
Same exact, and I think George Lucas, Scorsese.
No, they went to USC, I
believe. All right, whatever.
Brian Williams from NBC's Nightly News.
There you
he
go.
He did not go to Brookdale.
Yeah,
good.
He did.
I thought he didn't even graduate from high school.
That's the
you
same
don't have
thing.
To graduate from high school to go to Brookdale.
Yeah, it literally is the same thing. It's the equivalent.
All right, let's. So we're going to see scene one as Dave laying down and a very horny Pepper crawling up his body and getting right. Do you see it getting right into the beard porn immediately since these are only 40 second shots?
I think we're going to want to tease it a little with maybe some unbuttoning of the shirt.
Uh huh.
She's good. Pepper also needs to tell her to bring down the tighty whities. We did buy them, or I bought them because I believe in taking this shoot very seriously.
Good.
Much to the anger of some of my co-stars.
Why are you mad about it, Pep?
It's just depressed and disgusted.
What's the matter? It's time to pay up.
Was there an option to flame me out of this, though?
Just teaching Derek how to do this.
I do not like the idea of 40-second shots here.
We can do it however you want. It's about posting it. So if you want a longer video, that's cool. We can do that, but then I'll need to go home to post it.
No, I want to do three different 40-second videos.
Okay.
We could do a couple takes of each, too, if necessary.
Oh, sure. Why not?
Let me just help Dan out with my camera.
All right. Work on him with it. Because we only got an hour to use the set. Here's a little red hair. Go bring that vodka over here, some Tito's, which, Pepper, I know quite a bit of it is gone now. Little red hair, go grab a mic. Why did you think it would be a good idea for Bobby Slayton to have drinks before the mask?
Because isn't the point of Unmasked to take the mask off and show who you are?
Yeah, but I think the difference for him under his mask would be a sober person and the way he's lived his life.
He was a chatty Cathy yesterday.
Yeah, he was. All right, we're getting ready to shoot this. So this is the song we're going to be using. Nobody's got any other ideas?
What about Creep by fucking Radiohead?
You know Radiohead has disowned that song. I want no part of it. By the way, this vodka is almost without smell.
Oh, yeah. There's nothing there.
Oh, I like it. Bom, this song? Bom, bom.
I don't know why it takes this long to teach somebody how to use a phone. Very excited about this shoot, though. Beard porn, which I'd like to change the name of this to monkey red-haired beard porn.
A whole new genre.
I hope so. So, Dave, let's get you down in spot. You got your tighty whities?
Yeah, in the other room.
Yeah, get them, and you can't get changed in front of our girl intern.
Why not?
Pep, you don't have to go tighty whities.
That's cool.
Why not take care of you?
I'm not looking for any special treatment.
What is the thing with you with this? What is this about? You really want to see Dave naked?
No, not necessarily. Mm-hmm. I don't want to feel like they can't.
Oh, I see. You want to be one of the fellas. Yeah. I don't even treat Darren like one of the guys. I'm already watching out for him.
Yeah.
You still with your girlfriend?
No, we're not.
For real, broke up this time.
Yeah,
right?
For real. She's got a new boyfriend.
Who's she with now?
I don't know the guy.
I like him to be my new intern. He seems like he's got to get up and go. That it needs to be a winner.
I don't think he knows how to film like me, though, Ronnie.
Bomb chicka bomb bomb.
Here comes Dave. Tighty White is on. Now, are you excited because you get a free pair of underwear out of this? Is that what
yeah.
this is all about?
This is, yeah, in fact, I'm getting to keep all three.
Yeah.
It's brand new.
All right. Now, lay back down. Just get a test shot on that. Lay back down so we can. And let's get a test shot on Dave. Very funny underwear, by the way, Dave. They're almost Pampers. They're really... Yeah.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah. Dave, you're going to be getting rid of the shirt for the shoot.
Oh, all
It'll
right.
be funnier.
Okay.
It'll be funnier because your underwear is hysterical.
It's a little cold, but all right.
Yeah.
I'll do it.
The socks are a nice touch.
Yeah, leave the socks
on. The sweat socks.
It's chilly in here today for some reason.
I find out where to start the song from immediately and give me some time counts on it, too. Because what I first want... is like a nice long shot of Dave just laying there. Oh, by the way, pop him up with some. That's it. Grease daddy down. Give that to Dave. Make sure he gets plenty of liquor.
Oh, thank you. Almost forgot about that.
Yeah.
I was so euphoric about getting in tighty whities on a Friday.
Do you want a glass, Dave?
No.
Yeah, leave the socks on, Dave. They're perfect. So we get a nice long shot of Dave And let's bring up the
song off
here.
Now?
Doesn't need. I just need him to give the...
Give a sample shot?
Yeah, give a sample shot so he knows what we're going for here. Board porn.
Dude, how do I film again?
Beard porn. Boy, this fucking film major has no idea how to push the on button.
Is this your directorial debut?
I can't really talk about that, honey.
okay, just here, there you go. You're all set up. Just come to the to the Dave man with the camera if you have any questions.
Yeah, get that shot in. And, yeah, start the music. See, I think from there it's almost right there.
What's up?
You don't even have to say anything, Dave. Just lay there looking like yourself. All right, let's just go do the first shot. Just going to be Dave. That's going to be one. So we'll come in to Dave as being the first shot.
All righty. This is so exciting.
Yeah.
I do feel like this is sort of a premiere for me. Like, you know, I've wanted to get into movies for a long time.
You belong in movies.
I think so.
Welcome to Hollywood, bitch. No, let's get on all fours.
I have to get on all fours.
No, I'm just using a metaphor. All right,
let me
know. You got the music where we're ready to go? And, yeah, we'll have to pop this off. And on my raid, we're going to bring up the music first.
Monitor.
And then it'll be action. Ready? Dave, let's get the shirt off.
I'm going to drink.
Yeah. What I don't want is you playing to the camera. I just want you looking. And I think you get a nice shot of him. Don't worry about coming up too fast. We got to kill 40 seconds with not a lot to look at here.
Just so everyone knows, when he gets 5, 4, 3, that means 5 seconds left.
Okay, gotcha. That's it.
He is a natural.
Yeah, he is.
I do admire his confidence.
All right, lay back down.
All right, I won't play up. I'm just going to give it to you. I'm just going to give you
Davey Mac Naturel.
And I'm just going to give you, Darren, I'm just going to give you the thing for when you're ready. I'm just going to touch you on the shoulder because I've seen that in films as well when we're doing intimate shots like this. Let's see what this one looks like, though, because I worry about him looking too show busy. All right. Yeah.
No, if he wants to do close-ups, you literally have to walk. It's not like that kind of camera.
Have to walk it up.
Yeah.
And make sure you run over his body and into and just
everything's
look.
Covered. So.
Yeah, Dave. Just look. You don't have to play to the camera at all. Act like you don't even know he's there. I want your own fantasy going on in your head.
Just look. I'm
going
to think about something else.
And then maybe on the countdown, you just look and give a nice, sexy look to the thing.
A nice,
but
sexy
without
look.
Being over.
Okay.
You know.
All right.
Am I ending up on Dave's face? In this?
Yeah. Okay. Why not? Because this is beard porn, not armpit porn.
Good.
All right.
Start at the socks, though.
All right. Let's ready. Bring up the music.
All right, we have music in the room the full time?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, let's get that posted right away on 202 Friends. I think that's ready. Woo! Holy shit. Wow, we got one in the bag that quickly. This is coming along great. Now,
send
what
it to Chris Stanley.
Send 202.
Send it up immediately, Chris, and we'll try to get a quick watch on this. Very excited about it, though. It's really going places.
Thank you, Ronnie, for going this place. Opportunity.
Hey, can I tell you something, Dave? Seriously?
Yeah.
Thank you. Because, it's my vision, but you're the paint on my palette right now.
Now, you said something about a part in Transformers 3?
No.
If I do this?
No, that's a different party you're going to be going to. Dad, I want to meet you with some people. I think they're going to like you. I think we're all going to have fun. You know, it's going to be freeing.
Oh, this is starting to feel like a Seagal situation.
Yeah.
I thought, you know, getting naked on a couch was going to help me get into mainstream. You told
There'll
me
There'll be
that.
A stream.
Yeah, apparently, back to piss stuff. Apparently, Steven Seagal did this to Jenny McCarthy when she was younger and said, you look really right for this part. Take off your clothes and lay on my couch. And then she cried and ran out. But Seagal's apparently, and I've heard about this for years, he's had a long history of this. How do you feel about that shot, Darren?
I started to giggle a little bit when I got into Dave's crotch, but I don't think there's going to be too much. There's not too much movement.
Here's what I do like about that.
There's nothing funny about the red monster.
In real life, that would happen. So I do want to leave that in. Yeah, I do want to leave that in.
Welcome to Saturday night in my world.
Art's imitating life.
How quickly are we going to be up on 202, friends?
Just have to wait for it to get to the email, and then I'll upload it. Hopefully it's a few minutes.
I don't want to wait a few minutes. I got an hour to fucking shoot. And I need you in here. Really thinking about having Hicks go completely naked. Oh. Just completely naked.
I think you should.
And I want one of the shots to go from asshole to ball sack and then up the shaft. It's never really been done properly.
There's no zoom on this, Ron. That's going to be...
Oh!
Small Dixie!
Small Dixie. It's still sending. Videos take a few minutes to send if we want to maybe start trying to lay out the second shot or something. We will have it before the end of the show, without doubt.
The second shot, lay back down again. So we're going to point from there. We're back with the music. But, no. Let's almost get him from the side.
I'll get rid of this.
Yeah. And you're taking that. And as you hear the music... Hicks will be slowly crawling up, Dave.
That's perfect.
Dave, you give the look to the camera like this is the greatest thing that ever happened, right? And as you're giving that look, Hicks will then start to beard porn with you. And that'll be the introduction to beard porn. So, unfortunately, this is more about Dave than it is Hicks. But there are no small roles in a Bennington film. Everybody's a star.
I feel good about this.
So remember, Hicks is your dream man. When you see him, he's your fantasy come to life.
Oh, that's one of the best things that I do as an actor. When I give what I call the Dave face of joy, which is simply...
That's perfect.
Yeah.
That's perfect.
That's what they're going to get.
That's what I like.
They're going to get that.
So am I going to have the camera on Dave and then pan over to Hicks as a reveal?
I think it's going to be a reveal.
Okay.
And then here comes Hicks.
Yeah.
And he's crawling up slowly, brushing. And then we get right into beard on beard. And then you guys have to look like it's the most ecstatic thing that ever happened to you.
Oh, don't worry. I'm a method actor. I'm actually enjoying it as we
speak. I'm a methadone actor. I just got off the things. Jimmy Schubert.
But I think, like D-Dog, you want Pepper to go crawl into the shot. You don't want to seek him out. That's the surprise.
Okay.
See what I mean?
Gotcha.
Okay.
It's really...
This is some of the most exciting work I've done, in my opinion.
Well,
and you know I'm a Twitty legend, but I've been wanting to do a film like this that shows off my romantic side for quite some time.
Well, first of all, this is the first time you've worked with a cast and crew this large.
That's true.
I mean, you've been doing this independent.
Yeah, I know. I always wanted to work
for... One man, one camera.
Sure.
You've been the rebel without a crew.
I know. I wanted to work
for Robert Rodriguez, Dave McDonald.
Yeah.
Now you're making a summer action blockbuster.
That's what I wanted to do. You know, it worked for Favreau. Why can't it work for Davey Mac?
Who?
John Favreau.
You see what I'm doing there when I say who? Like he's yesterday's news. What are we waiting for, Pep?
Let's see it.
Hasn't hit my email yet.
Come on, are you kidding me, Dave? Did this get sent out properly?
Yeah, it's sent as we always do it.
I don't want to spend all day on this fucking shoot.
I know. These fucking Twittios take a little bit of time.
Dave, if I'd known this was going to take so long, I would have fucking started it earlier. Because I'm losing sun, brother. And I want this to be a Miller Time shot.
We'll get these. I suggest, you know, we maybe start with the second one. While the first one is getting sent, and by the time, you know, we've kind of hammered out the second shot, first one should be there.
All right, perfect idea.
These twidios, you know, even Opie was talking about today, how long a 30-second, it takes his camera 13 minutes.
Wow, I had no idea.
Yeah.
All right, well, let's set up second shot then. Let's get you back down where you're going. Fez, get in your spot over there at Dave's feet. And we're going to move it from there straight up until finally it hits.
Yeah, Pepper.
No, right. Fez.
Fez.
Yeah, I'm not doing this to fucking Pepper.
What?
Yeah, I never had any plans to do this to fucking Pepper.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Well,
you don't understand.
That's like ruining my co-star.
What are you talking about? You got the old pro. You got the old man. You got the old man ready to roll.
All right.
How tight do you want the shot, Ron?
With Fez, do you have some kind of like one of those glowy things? Like, could you put some fucking oil over the camera?
That's called soft focus.
Very soft.
While I'm waiting, I'm gonna.
Let's move little red hair. Go over to hit the music cue.
Okay.
Show her where to hit it.
So,
take her over. Fez is trying to work it out. It's all coming down now. Beard porn. Pepper, no offense, but you're out.
Oh, it hurts, I think.
What I want you to do is think about that every day that it, you know, does necessarily come up in your life when you're like, what's with Bennington? And you go, look what he rescued me from.
Yeah.
Now, how come I didn't get rescued, Ron?
That's the thing that you can be asking yourself.
I just did a spit take with actual spit.
Yeah. All right, let's move it on over.
Let's go, Davey Max, ready.
Now, Fez, you know where you're going with this. Give me a quick walkthrough.
Okay. I start down here.
Mm-hmm.
I start kneeling down.
Yeah.
I come in.
Look what you're doing. You're blocking the shot.
Camera.
You got to come in from the side.
Yeah.
From the side, sexily.
Oh, so over the top of Dave. And then into the beard porn.
I do it again. Roll it all the way through.
Okay.
I'm just going to lay back. Now
right. Kneeling.
And then
climb in from the side.
Watch. You're not doing it very sexy, though, Fez. You're climbing. You want to slither in like a fucking snake.
You got to okay. You got to come in low, too. Head
low to the ground.
Dave's knees.
All right.
Do-do-do-do-do. There you go. Now, Dave, as he's coming up, I want you to give that funny look to okay. The fucking...
Do I give that look when he's rubbing me?
Yeah.
Shut up.
How about when you just first start to see him come up? Okay. Try it when you just first start to see
okay,
him.
Okay, we'll try that way.
Yeah, try it that way.
All right. Dave, we're not going to know he's in until he gets to, like, have this knee from you.
That's good
That's
point.
When he gets into the
call.
Shot.
Good call. So, Darren, you can even just go like this over your head.
Okay.
Hand signal when you fizz in the shot.
Okay.
All right, ready? Let's roll it. Your hand's on in too far, Fez.
Oh.
Yeah, you just gotta come down a little lower.
Yeah, you want to slither in. No.
Just in case?
No. Right. Ready, go? What are you doing? Where's the beard porn? Get right into beard porn for us. All right, are we ready to roll here?
Yeah, we're ready to roll.
Get back to places, everybody. Places. Places, because
okay.
I'm not going time and a half for lunch.
Okay.
Why did you move completely from where you were?
No, I'm
you moved out of the regular shot.
I had to move over here so Fizz can get over here.
All right, Jackie, music.
Mike.
funniest thing I've ever seen. Fez, you blew every rehearsal and then nailed the fucking shot. It was unbelievable. All right, let's get that one up and ready to take a quick look at it. Dave, your face was fucking hysterical.
Just in the nick of time, you got it. 39 seconds. D-Dog playing dangerous.
Yeah, he does. He plays it that way.
We needed the shot, Dave. I needed those extra couple seconds.
God, that was funny. All right, Fez, do me a favor. When you roll, why don't you roll over here?
Okay.
Let us take a look at a couple of things. But did you see the look that Dave was making?
You know, I really couldn't see it all that well from my beard angle.
Okay. So just show him your... just give me, like, a funny face right now. Now, give a, like, ecstasy face. That's pretty funny. That's pretty fucking good.
Eyes rolling back.
All right, now, here's the thing. I like that. Now, show him yours, Dave. Because... Show him your funny face is. Show it to Fez directly.
Okay. I go like this.
All right. Now, what I love about yours is could you, not do an impression, since do yours, but with a slight shadow of what he did there.
Okay.
Yeah. Like, do your eyes, but maybe his mouth. See if he can't do that. No, that doesn't look as happy. I want you to forget that. Go back to just your own feeling. No, that looks drunk. Go to your own feeling of ecstasy.
All right.
Oh, man. That's
actually pretty funny, though. It's pretty good. Now, where you are right now, stay with it. Keep doing it.
All right.
And make it a little lighter. Try not to be so... That's kind of good. That's kind of looking good. That's it. You're going better there because your ecstasy and anger is pretty good. So, like, Dave, he's going to come up, give you a little beard porn in this scene, right?
Okay.
You give your face, and then you turn and give it to him. You turn and give us ecstasy.
Okay.
Okay. I start beard porn on you. Give me a face. You give it back. I give you a face.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Alrighty.
How close do you want the camera on?
Give me a mid-close-up on this. A mid-close-up.
So just a proper two-shot?
Yeah. We're going to do a little blocking here. Okay. Have we sent that other one over to Pep?
Yep, still getting sent.
The first one, too?
Yeah, it's still uploading.
I really wanted to get fucking,
Should have it. I don't know what the fuck taking so long.
We're not losing this, though, right?
No, we definitely not losing it. You know what? In this fucking in this crazy satellite stuff, it's like sometimes the reception sucks. Usually it should be up there by now, but it'll definitely be there. Trust me. Just make sure you're constantly checking 202, friends. That's all. For now until tonight. Fuck it. Over the weekend too.
Where
are you going with my acting juice?
All right, so let's... Oh, fuck it. Acting juice.
He's trying to take it away from me.
Yeah. All right, let's get over and just block that shot out a little bit before we shoot.
I love the term block.
That's yeah.
Great. I really do feel like this is a good...
All right, Fez, your entire ass is out right now, so you might want to pull that in.
Sorry.
What don't you understand about pulling your pant up a little bit? All right.
Pepper, you owe me so much fucking...
Yeah, he owes you nothing.
I owe Rumpang.
All right, give me Dave, give me like the little happy face that you do.
Little one?
Yeah.
Just a little?
Yeah. And now you roll over, go to Fez's face, and start to give him face.
Like that?
Or... Yeah. But how about you go chin to chin, chin to right? Chin to chin first. But you guys have to try to feel something. You're being fucking... You're just acting like two animals.
Okay.
And now, look, neither one of you looks happy. Fez, calm the fuck down. So seriously, I can't tell you how unappealing what you're doing is. You look like you're trying to shit. Yes, softer.
Okay.
Act like
softer, slower.
Act like there's not a gun to your head while you're doing this.
I think I know now, what you want.
Yeah, you bring on a little sex. And then, Dave, I want you to take your face so Fez is exposed. You're giving him on the one side. And then Fez is doing his... You know, cum face.
So
he's giving him his
own
face. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Fez, and now look, Fez, you want to shadow, look, you remember where the camera is.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, work to the camera.
Ronnie, when he moves over there, do you want me to sort of follow and like.
Yeah, that's perfect. That's good. But I really like that a lot. I like that a lot. All right. So it starts out phase two, you know, Dave, look, Dave, you're going from left, right, left, and doing your funny face at the camera at start because that's where we ended up. Right. So block it through and just follow in slow motion. Then we're going from almost chin to chin. Now Fez comes out. And not so fast with your ecstasy phase. Take a couple beats, let it build, and then you're in pure ecstasy. And Dave, I think that you can spend, so I'd like to see it like 3 to 5 seconds with Fez, with Dave getting his, you know, Dave close up into 3 to 5 seconds, and then ending with Fez.
Yeah, indeed, Doug. End it when it ends. Doesn't have to go to 40.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. All right. With that, we feel like we got this. We're ready to go about music up.
I would like to know my motivation. That's what the actors say.
Well, your motivation would be this.
Yeah.
Think of, like, for some reason, you're finally in the spot. You two old janitors finally have a couple of minutes together. The kids have gone home, and you're fucking each other outside the teen pool.
And we've had too much acting juice.
Well, one of you has.
All right. It's in his beard, by the way.
At least it's not ketchup and onion rings is all I smell at Fez.
That could be the name of this fucking
thing. I like it, yeah.
All right, everybody remembers?
Yes, I remember. Mm-hmm.
All right, ready? Music? We may have to recut this.
No fucking way. That was way too intimate.
Yeah, it was.
There's nothing wrong with that.
There's a lot wrong with
that. In the moment.
There's a lot wrong with that.
And quite sincerely, one of you forgot that the camera was there, which is like they think is a good thing for acting, but this was supposed to be for comedic purposes. So we stopped playing, like, hey, wouldn't it be funny to make fun of this? And just started to fucking do it. I think we want to re-hit that one.
Well, okay. I think part one was loaded, so is it up?
Part one will be up soon.
I want to get your hair just a little crazier.
Because it's kind of funny.
So
yeah, your hair doesn't get played that much here.
Pepper,
No. It just lays.
I sent Pepper that part three, but just don't post that, Pepper, if we're going to do another one.
So are we calling this ketchup and onion rings?
No. That's too much of an inside joke.
Stop.
Oh, this is really uncomfortable.
So the part one will be up in just a matter of seconds, if not minutes.
On 202 Friends.
Because on 202 Friends on Twitter.
Very exciting. Very exciting.
My juice. Why do people keep taking my juice?
Because I'm going to kick it over, Dave.
Yeah. You know he needs his acting juice.
I'm like fucking Mickey Rourke over here, pal.
Now, by the way,
I need substance.
In your underpants.
I do have to say that I feel like I'm witnessing something amazing right now.
Yeah,
like,
you're wrong. This is really...
And you've been into the acting juice.
Yeah. Boy, you got to get him out of here after the show.
What would you like to say, director?
Yeah.
No, I'm not even remotely buzzed. I don't know if it's the weed or what, but my tolerance is different.
So you guys feel like we need to reshoot that other one, Dave, right?
Yeah.
If you want to, you're the director, Ronnie B. If you liked it, liked it. If you didn't, you didn't.
I just want to bring the most out of Fez. It's so close.
Okay.
It's
just really uncomfortable, but
oh,
I'll
yeah,
do
it's
it.
Really bad.
I suffer from my art.
No shit. All the mics are on, so we can talk to them.
I have a hard time knowing how we can top this scene with the third the third in our trilogy. All right, let's go over and do this. You guys remember the blocking, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember.
Filming it from the same angle again?
Same angle. Everything you did was perfect. Fez, get into
be
it.
Be aware of camera.
Yeah, be into it a little less. Make it a little less about you and a little more about the comedic angle of this.
Ron, if we're going to like look to edit this together,
yeah,
we might want to just do a little bit of a two-shot from farther away just so I can hide the cuts.
No, I don't even think we need that. I never want to edit together.
Okay.
It'll just be shit.
Just want it up close.
Yeah.
People can do that on their own anyway.
Yeah.
If they want to. If they want to, that's a serious freak right there.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, hold on, Fez. You got to fucking...
Is this my position?
Are we going to film now?
Yeah, we're about to film, and music. It's sad because there's parts of one I like, the parts of two. I can't get Fez to the money shot. He's having too much trouble. He's having too much fun just lying on top of you.
Part one now, is up I'm on Twitter.
One more time.
I'm now thinking the first shot was the first of the two shots was better. We're running low on time here, though, Fezzy, to get in all three.
We got to get to the end shot a little faster, too, there. We almost ran out of time.
Yeah, I know.
Oh,
he's
okay.
It happened both times. But I think his face was way funnier in the first of the takes, too. So, yeah, let's just run with the first, and then we'll move over to the third. Now we need an idea.
Part one is now up on 202 Friends, Beard Porn. Yeah.
Part one is just him. Wait, was that our third shot, including the Dave laying there?
That's our third shot. We had Dave laying there. Fez comes in on Dave to start beard porn is scene two. And then this was scene three, full engage beard porn.
All right, I think we're going to print scene three, one. Let's go with one and let two stay
on. Scene three? Okay, so Pepper, that's scene three.
Yeah.
Part three, I mean.
Yeah, so now we're into part four, if you want to end this. I mean, do you guys want to actually come on each other? Is that a thing? Really funny.
I don't think that's... beard porn is not about the sex, Mr. B.
I see.
It's just about
all right, well, what could be a funny way to get out of it, then? Or is the three scenes enough?
I think the last scene could be us sitting up, maybe holding our hand, putting our arms around...
The afterglow.
You got cigarettes?
Pepper can roll us, maybe. And what we do is, or Darren has cigarettes, and we kind of just stare at the camera like that, you know? Give one last acknowledgement that, yeah, we just beard porned your ass.
Would this be funny, though? Just let's have Fez playing with Dave's chest there a little bit.
Sure.
And you just roll down and put your hand in the Hanes, just under the Hanes a little bit.
Okay. Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah. Really.
What if you end it with, like, getting a close-up of like, their faces? They're sitting up now. They're done. They have the cigarettes. And they're both making their iconic faces.
Yeah, that's what the Davy Macker said.
Oh, sorry, Dave.
All right, so let's lay down how we're going to put
acting
it.
Juice.
One cigarette for Dave, nothing for Fez.
Fez doesn't smoke.
Doesn't smoke.
Do we want to have him pull the pack out of Dave's underwear?
You might now. Look, what's the use of us having things if everybody's gonna spy?
I know.
They have us put up curtains, and now they're spying.
The critical error was to make the curtains on the outside,
so wrong.
That people can easily just pull them open.
You guys are invited in, but
for the record, we had our curtains drawn. It's other people undrawing them.
And we are shooting beard porn. Are you aware of that?
No, absolutely.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
What the hell?
Hi, everybody.
I only recognize Troy.
I thought this was a closed set.
Who are these other two schmizbos?
They're investors.
In the fast-growing beard porn industry?
Yes, I've got expenses. All right, so where do we decide to go with this last shot? And is shot one up on the internet yet?
It's up on 202 Friends.
All right, we'll be looking for some of the responses there. We got to shoot this fast and quick because... Yeah.
Okay.
So 202 Friends.
Is that, Ronnie, or would you not like that?
What's that? The cigarettes?
Where do you want the cigarettes to go?
No, you're just going to have one in your mouth.
Okay.
It should look like you're over.
Okay.
Laying down.
Laying down. Okay. Yes, feels so good.
What about, all right, it goes from that. All right, I don't know how to tell you this. Do we have time to get them a tan?
No.
Because it really does look like two seals have had bearded sex.
With my skin, the...
All right, that looks good. Stay right there. Yeah, that's a good shot. Excellent. Yeah.
The light on the camera is actually giving me a tan with my awful
oh, that's good.
Skin.
All right, so what have we got planned? So then it's Dave has the cigarette in his mouth.
Well, I guess we should beard it, then look at the camera.
Oh, that's good, Fez. I like that expression.
Okay.
And then we look at each other lovingly one last time and then back at the camera.
Yeah.
Do you want me to sort of do a real slow zoom?
Yeah, and then... That's good, Dave. Yeah. And then can we show, like, Fez's hand is just kind of going south?
Yeah.
And then we'll go back to the funny expression?
Just focus on the hand.
Right, yeah.
So when is Fez's hand...
After we look longingly in our eyes, we'll go back at the camera back onto Fez's hand.
Okay, so I'll zoom in. Yeah. When I start to come back out, that's when the hand will go down.
Yeah.
Right, but it's going to be face, eyes... Face and
yeah. Okay.
Don't go ahead until I start to come back out, or we're gonna miss
yeah.
it.
Okay.
Music.
Oh, Jane, Riley, should I smoke a cigarette to lead off?
Yeah.
Or...
Smoking the lead off and then put it down. We're going to reshoot this and take this cigarette away because you've ruined my film. You've ruined my film with the stupid cigarette. You stopped all your funny faces.
Okay.
That one went up the ring. I couldn't stop it. It went up to like 45 seconds.
Oh, deep talk.
What happened? What's wrong with that? I completely apologize for this.
That was arousing.
Oh, God, no. I hope not.
I can chuck the cigarette after the opening shot. I'm a pro. You want me to chuck it? I'll just do a cigarette and then chuck it.
Yeah, I mean, the cigarette isn't funny enough.
Okay.
I wanted to look like a pre-cum cigarette, but...
I got an idea, Mr. B.
Mm-hmm.
The last shot, maybe that's when I go to the cigarette. We do all our bullshit, and then we go to the last shot with the cigarette. Or no?
Hmm.
No, all right, fucking...
Because you're coming back into it for the second time.
No, you're right. Fuck the cigarette. Okay, here you go, D-Dog. Okay.
I just don't know if I even want to put this out now. I'm not sure.
Don't get discouraged. Every big film has their problems.
I don't know.
Avatar wasn't made in one day, Mr. B.
Avatar stinks. Fez was right.
I'm one of those actors with a lot of ideas.
Right.
Akin to a Tom Sizemore.
But here's what I don't like. Like you said, Avatar wasn't made in one day. Then why do I have to make mine in one day?
Because it's going to be better and bigger than Avatar.
If he's going Sizemore, should we introduce the vodka to the picture?
No. No props.
Dave is anything but Sizemore.
Ouch.
I don't need to be the fucking DP doing that. I don't need Barry Sonnenfeld.
All right, I'm not liking what I'm getting from some of the earliest fucking feedback that we're getting. I mean, look at this. I wish I'd never seen it. My wife's vagina has a bigger bulge. Creepiest video ever. Dave, next time bring your penis to work with you. Disturbing. Holy hiked up bloomers, Dave.
What are you talking about? That's how I wear my underwear. The shirt said that. Fuck this.
I'm back to the acting juice.
Those are the biggest underpants I've seen. I'm getting bad buzz for my film.
No, and you know who else?
We need a new focus group.
Ronnie.
All right, looks like a girdle came up.
You just had John Landau in here.
Yeah.
You know who else got bad buzz?
Who's that?
John Landau and Peter fucking Jackson, who did not direct Titanic. That was Jim Cameron. Those guys got plenty of bad buzz. Excuse me, I have to take the underwear out of my crack. I feel good about this. This is one of the best projects I think I've done in a long time.
Let's get over and try to shoot this last scene.
Okay.
I don't know if we can ever follow what we started with, though.
If we don't like it, we don't like it. We have to send it or post it.
All right, Dave, get in position.
Remember, this could always be used on the DVD outtakes.
I have a feeling I'm going to be pulled from this. What about... Dave ends like with a cheesy thumbs up.
Okay.
Thumbs up is always funny and stupid.
Okay, so we're doing.
Let's just run through without. So it's you're both there smiling.
Smiling at each other.
Yeah. Now remember, you're playing to the camera, boys. Why is your hand there, Fez? No, we don't start from there. We gotta have action in the scene. Yeah. All right. So you're both kind of feeling good about yourself. Back to a little beard porn. And how about Fez starts to head down a little bit, head south, and then it's a close-up, and we move right in on Dave V's face, and it ends. That's fucking funny.
You want Fez's head in there?
No.
That's
no.
Perfect, yeah.
So, Fez, move your arm out, because I want to make it look like you're heading south.
So you'd be your head. So we're getting rid of Fez's head altogether.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Can we run through it once more? Yeah, run through it.
Face.
Fez, remember, you're working the camera first, though. You guys are satisfied. You're already finished.
Yeah.
Boom. And then back to face. Fez is heading down. And, yeah, wait a couple beats before the thumb goes up.
Wait a couple beats.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not a lot, but it's all we have. No.
I'm loving it.
It's not a lot, but it's all we have.
This is as long as the real board port.
All right. We're counting it down. Ready for the music. 3, 2, 1. Yeah, we might be heading on a dud. All right, people are actually saying, is this beard porn or adult baby fetish? Come on,
beard
guys.
Porn.
I feel like I won that fucking contest on Bravo, and now everything's going bad on me.
Project Greenlight, yeah.
How much time we got left in the show, Pep?
7 minutes.
We might be able to get one shot. Fez, you weren't acting like you were going south. You just fell out of the picture completely.
Oh, okay.
How was the camera on? Anything?
Camera looked good. There just wasn't a lot for you to do there.
Yeah, especially at the front of it. We don't need all the beard rubbing at the front.
Yeah, we've already seen the beard rubbing.
Okay.
It's, if I may say, it's more about after sex nuzzling, right?
Right.
This is how you know Fez hasn't... had sex. No, I'm just saying, you just want to be the less...
I will never work with you again in beard porn.
He's too fast.
He's fast and aggressive.
Too fast. You know what I mean?
there's times for the fastness and the quickness. But
he
this
definitely
is
fast and aggressive.
This is post-sex. This is, we just done the nasty.
Oh, Jesus Christ. I can't even keep up with the tweets since I clicked it to 100 more comments. I thought you popped in.
It's been like 50 seconds.
I hope the good ones have started coming in.
By the way, again, I must reiterate this at least once every three shows. I am a grower, not a shower.
And they're calling it eunuch porn.
And people are, like, upset that I don't have a huge hard-on for gay beard porn. Where are your priorities?
All right, this is what the film is doing for people. My balls just shrank up into my body.
Is that a bad thing? That shows
so.
Some emotional connection to the film.
I just saw Dave's pubes, so I don't want to see anybody
All
else.
Right.
I haven't shaved down in a long time.
All right, let's get back into it. Another right. We thought that this whole time that Gap sucked because of Paul O. Well, Dave is the one who's gotten both of these in.
Okay. I think it's 1D dog. You've got to be quicker. You know, you can go for 20 seconds if you want.
I'm going with what you guys do.
Okay, you're right.
All
right. Not yet.
Now, Fezzy, you know the difference between happy and sinister, right?
Yeah.
What are you telling you? What's your face saying right now?
Too sinister?
Yeah, but what are you telling yourself inside?
That the dream just came true, and right. I'm in ecstasy.
Now that's it. Ready? Music.
I think that was it.
Well, it's going to have to be it, based on time and time alone.
It felt good, that one, but I don't know. I don't look at the director nor the cameraman.
Seemed
so
like a keeper to me.
I'm actually thinking about having my name taken off this.
Why?
What's that name that they use when they're not happy with the film anymore?
Oh, yeah. It's there's initials there. Joe Westerhaus used to use it.
Yeah.
I know exactly what you're talking about. And they even made a movie with that title.
All right, it's all coming up on 202 Friends
weekend. I'm going to wear this underwear home because I've never felt sexier.
I'm just
going to let you know right now.
Yeah, I can't believe you're in clean underwear. It's fantastic.
It feels great. It really does. Now, I'm not promising when I get home there's not going to be three stains at least, each one with their own separate thing.
That is a long trip.
Pepper?
Yes.
You are familiar with the term indentured servitude, are you not, sir?
Yes.
Yeah. This is one you won't be out of. I'll be calling you 30 years from now to get a diamond for me. You'll be rat-holing fucking boxes.
Where and when?
Fez, way to come through.
Thank you.
And I can't. After seeing some of the faces you make, Fez, I find it hard to believe that you'll ever get laid. I really do think...
Even the last one, he was still going way too fast
way
for
too
a...
Way too fast, and then the way he went when he was heading south, just like he was sliding down a fire pit to get out of it.
I was just going to count today towards having done it.
You might as well. It actually will be like... some kind of anti-gay fucking tape making its way around the internet.
It's going to become a public service announcement now.
Yeah, it may. All right, that is it for us, gang's 202 friends to see these things. All right, yeah, let's take a look.
This is like a Nightmare Fiona Apple video.
Bring the sound up on this so we can...
Oh, this is horrible.
By the way, the music worked out perfectly. Oh, God, just a close-up on his crotch.
That's not bad.
It does look like my grandma's girdle.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I don't like the way that he looks oily and almost sweaty. Like something horrible is happening. This actually looks like old film. Looks like a 1950s smoker going
we
on.
Could, we could pass it off.
Yeah. You just expect to see Bobby Kennedy getting a blowjob in the background. Beard porn, by the way, taking off with you guys the other day. And what we really wanted is on real beard porn sites. We need somebody to get it on the gay sites. That's what we're after right now. It's already a hit with us. Now we got to go viral on this.
Wait, we have to go. We have to put it on the gay sites?
Well, I want not us. We're going to get somebody else.
Oh,
because
okay.
Opie was just telling me that Sam is already on gay sites for something that they did as the weird little gay boy. So if Sam and Dave could both be on gay sites, it would make my fucking day.
Well, yeah. I mean, I don't see how.
Let's see how big we can get this.
No, I think we're kind of like a straight
That's
show.
That's what he said.
Yeah. I wouldn't mind saying it to straight sites.
You think
sites.
It's straight?
Yeah, saying it's straight sites.
But this is really funny. He's like, and then, Opie's saying to me, Dave has this really disturbing look on his face. And the next thing I know, Fez does, as if this wasn't planned, as if you guys were just so into it, you started to make these expressions. And I'm just saying to him, yeah, I know, it's odd. Really strange. But he was the one who told me Sam is already on the gay sites as weird little gay boy.
I guess. I know he's kissed he kissed a homeless guy once, so maybe that's why he's on the gay site.
Oh, we can top that with beard porn.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not sure, we need to be on all the gay sites, just...
I don't know whether we should stop these. I think we keep them coming, $29.95 apiece.
I would like a little cut of that, then. I mean, if you're going to...
Don't fucking get strong on me, Dave. Don't start strong. You know what expenses I have.
I said would like. That's hardly strong.
I got your phone. I got to keep that going at all times. Darren, my DP, double penetration.
He did a very good job as a cinematographer.
If beard porn goes off the way I think it will with you guys,
mm-hmm.
We got to do an ass to mouth after that. I mean, we got to keep this thing going.
Well, all right, but...
Out front, Dave, we see Fez on Broadway today doing his walk, his I'm not going to break down today walk. So HTG and I were smoking, having a little smoke out front. So we see him. I go, let's give him the Malachi Crunch. So we come running up on each side and, just kind of both come in on each side of him and just kind of go shoulder to shoulder with him. I'm not making this up even slightly. In the Broadway, 10:30 in the morning, he goes like this. He kind of goes fetal real quick and goes like this. Oh.
I because thought I was a goner.
Two people leaned into his shoulder. Not the I'm freaking out, fighting for your life, just throwing punches and kicking and screaming, which would be the normal funny thing to laugh at. But it almost sounded like, I give.
I use just stop, life. Drop, and roll for every emergency.
The life going out of him, it sounds
then,
like.
I know. And it was like letting the fucking air out of a gay balloon. Just. And then he went to, he hugs me like it's a punked episode. Then falls to one knee and holds his chest like I've killed him by leaning into him. And I'm not acting like, oh, we hit him hard. We just did that. We're going to crowd you on either side.
A wide spectrum of emotions.
I felt the air leave my body.
That's nothing to brag about. You live in New York City.
You can't
give up that quickly.
There's been problems in Times Square before. It's happened.
Yes, but that's not the way to handle the problem. The problem isn't just to fucking die.